Welcome.
Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. My name is Ariel Coco, and today I have a video for you guys of the very beginner slash the very basics of Ariel silks. So today I'm going to be explaining the very basic tricks that you should know when either first starting Ariels, or if you are more advanced and you want to just brush up or make sure that you are doing the basic skills right and you have them so you know that you can build off of them more from there. So if you are excited for this video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up. And without further ado, let's get started. So for this, I would make sure to first understand what the plumb line is. That is directly underneath where you have your silk attached, standing directly underneath that, not behind it. So you're right underneath it and the silk just falls straight next to you and then right behind you. You are underneath your plumb line. Then one pose that you build off many other poses on is standard, and that looks like this. So getting into this is pretty easy, but if you want a more in-depth version of this, I want you to go check out the video that I posted explaining this more in depth. So all you have to do to get to that video is click right up there. But basically you build off this pose for a lot of other poses. So knowing how to do this is pretty important so that you can get into greater poses, bigger ones, prettier ones. Another thing that you should know is flexed feet look good sometimes, but me sitting here trying to pose for a picture, this is not a great look, but pointing your toes and creating those lines make things look a lot better. But if you are doing a move that I just did kind of there, in choreography, it can look really good. It can look good to go here and like point your toes and come down, but it can also look good to flex them and then come down. It kind of makes a different feel for your routine or whatever you're doing. Point usually is a lot more dainty and creates those lines, and then flexed is a lot harsher, but it also can really add good to the mood of your choreography, of your routine, of anything that you plan on using it for. Another thing that you should know is that aerial silks, aerial yoga, is a lot of core work and a lot of arm work. So if you are planning on working out beforehand or working out so that you can get better at aerials, definitely be doing a lot of ab workouts and a lot of arm workouts so you can pull yourself up and do different things in your routine. Another thing I would definitely learn how to do is a flip. And I love, love, love flips. They're one of my favorite tricks ever, and I made a whole video explaining on how to do them and a bunch of different types. There's like one leg, two legs, straight legs, bent legs, one leg and then the other leg, my personal favorite. So if you want to watch that video, please do. I will have it up in that corner right up there. So click through, watch that after this video or right now so that you can learn how to do lots of fun flips. And then some more good tricks to know are some basic inversions. And I have not done a video on inversions yet, but if you would like me to, give this video a thumbs up and leave me a comment below and tell me if you want to see inversions or if you would like to see more video on backbend. So please, please leave your request down below if you want to see an inversion video or a backbend video. So I'm going to show you a couple, the very basics of each one, of inversions and backbends. One good inversion is this shoulder stand. Then you can do different legs from there. You can do a lot of different poses from that shoulder stand. And it's pretty easy too. You take yourself, depending on which way you want to face, put it over your head and onto your shoulders, and then grab up. You're going to have like a little necklace here. Move forward kind of like you do for a front flip. Go down until you can feel the pressure of the silk on your shoulders, and then hold on tight and use one leg to kick up and then straighten your body line out and point your toes. Then you can go into stag legs, split legs, whatever you feel like you want to have in your routine. Another good inversion to know how to do is just the upside down one like you do before standard, which looks like this. And that one is pretty simple. You put it on your hips right about where your pants end, not above your hips, just in between your tailbone and your hip bones. And then lean back flat into tabletop top so it stays there. Open your legs to the side, stretch them out, point your toes, and lay backwards. And you are good here. You are safe in this position. I promise you. The more swinging you do, you can't get out. If you swing too far this way, you're just gonna be stuck here. You're not gonna be able to like fly out or whatever. And if you swing too much this way, you're just gonna stand up. So know that you are safe in this position. It's a good one to know how to do, either with your legs bent like this, straight, one leg, the other leg, in front, behind. Whatever you want to do with this pose is a really good transitional one. It's fun to do different things with your legs, flexed feet, pointed feet. Depends on what mood you're going for, but this is a great inversion to go to. You're going to stand in front of your silk, arms around and behind, and catch it underneath your armpits and your shoulder blades. Then walk forward in front of your plumb line and arch backwards into this. That's a great one for stretching. It's not really a pose, but there are things that you can do off of it. You can go into this one, and then from there do many more poses. All right, guys, that is all I have for you today. If you liked this video, don't forget to leave me a thumbs up. Tell me down below in the comments if you want an inversion video or a backbend video, and I will be reading those, responding. I'll try to respond as many as I can, liking them. I want to stay interactive with you guys. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel. I will have it right there. And with that, lots of love from Ariel Coco, and I will see you guys in another video. Goodbye!